Hello Leos, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the first 10 days of February. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to the situation. And if the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign, Venus sign and the name sign. And for the personal reading, the details are given in the description box below. So Leos, you are having a pretty good time. Some major changes are coming your way and happy times are definitely coming your way. Things are moving very fast and you are in a very good position as for now. So I would like to see what I feel is you people are at some end of some negativity. It is a tapering type of a situation now, or I should say the tail end of some sadness, or tail end of some problem, tail end of something which was bothering you, to be honest. Okay, that is how I feel like putting it. It's a tail end of something which was bothering you, and you are walking away from that negativity with the Six of Swords. You have some support. You definitely have some support. Still, you have that support. You have some resources, whatever it is. You are walking towards peace. You are leaving away that negativity, that tension, whatever it was in your life. You are leaving that negativity behind and you are choosing peace, or you are moving actually towards peace, or whatever it is. Now, this can be actual movement, or it can be just a mental movement that you have worked upon yourself, and you have or you are in a process of achieving that peace. Because I'm saying this because there was a time, it has, again I would say, it may be have passed for some of you. Maybe you are still some of you in this phase, but definitely with the High Priestess and with the Hangman, you were in a position that you were building upon yourself. You were really not mixing up with people, or you were not taking actions, I should say, or you were tied up in a situation, not in a negative way, but in a positive way. That's what I was saying. Tied up to this in the sense that you were not making any moves, and that was a wise step. And maybe you voluntarily decided, or maybe for some of you, you were forced to be in such a situation that or if you are not doing it, then you are advised to do it. Okay, again, it will be different for different people, because there are so many views and everybody has a different phase of life. So if you are not doing it, the guidance for you is do not take action as for now. Just be in touch with yourself, be in touch with your inner intuition. Just listen to what your heart has to say, what your soul has to say, what your intuition or the gut feeling has to say, because that is going to give you the right decision or the right mode of action as to how you're supposed to proceed forward. Whatever the situation is, if you are in, you are supposed to be like this. Okay, that's what I'm trying to say with the High Priestess. Because, and there is enlightenment over here at the head. So it's not that if you are not moving forward, if you're not taking an action, that doesn't mean, even maybe for other people they may feel that why are you not moving forward, why are you so stuck, why are you not taking some action. But that it is the wise step, it is the right step and the wise step for you right now. And this is the guidance also for you, for whosoever is right now in this position. Okay, and for those of you who have crossed this position, we'll proceed with the cards. But as for you, it is a very, very strong message for you, Leos, a very, very strong message for you. Do not act. Just listen to your intuition. Just be in touch with yourself. And you're just supposed to sort of meditate or be in touch with your spirituality or whatever it is. But definitely try to focus on yourself. That is also something which I would like to say. Focus on yourself rather than focusing on all the negativities or the problems or whatever it is. Give time to yourself and heal yourself, because we have the Empress and we have the Strength card. Okay, so now what I would like to say here is, with the Strength card, definitely whatever it was from which you are sailing away was not that easy. It took a lot of strength, or it is still taking a lot of strength out of you, and you are dealing with it. Whatever it is, you are dealing with it with beautiful, in a graceful way, in a beautiful way, and with dignity. Okay, you have maintained that dignity of yours in whatever the situation is, and you have not made any rash decision. You have not made, or you are not advised to make. Okay, whatever it is, you have been very sensible, mature, graceful, dignified in coming out of whatever it was, you've listened to your inner voice and you've done everything very gracefully and with the Empress, this is what you're supposed to do. Give time to yourself. It is a time of new beginnings. It is a very fertile card. It's a time of new beginnings. Maybe some of you are about to become a parent, maybe a few of you at least. Okay, some of you. But then it is a time for self-healing. Give time to yourself. Focus on yourself. That's what I was saying. Focus on your self-worth. And this is the time you need to give yourself. It has, maybe the situation demands a lot of strength from you still, okay, but you have, and maybe healing yourself also demands a lot of strength from you, because healing itself is not a very easy process. It takes a lot of energy to come out of the negative situation and be in a positive situation. Okay, apart from that, just see now, coming to the positive side, we have the Knight of Pentacles. It may move slow, but it is definitely there. It is an opportunity which is a solid, stable foundation. It's going to be there. It is coming for you. Okay, with the Ace of Swords, and we have the Wheel of Fortune and the Sun. So the things are moving pretty fast. You will have happiness. You will have the ultimate happiness, whatever it is. Think you will have the clarity of vision, your clarity of thoughts. You will have, it is something divinely guided. You are definitely getting some opportunity, which is going to be, you will be very passionate and happy about it. Just see, you have the Ace, you have the Wheel of Fortune. Things are turning in your favor, and the Sun card is there, which is ultimately the most happy card or the happiest card of the deck. Now coming to the Three of Hearts, celebrations. You are celebrating, so you are victorious. You are coming out of it, either whatever the situation was, either you are coming out of it successfully or you won something. Won in not in the sense it wasn't a battle, it not that sense, but then your happiness is your victory, sort of. Okay, you will be able to deal with it and you will be able to come out of it, and that is the ultimate victory actually. Okay, for me that is the ultimate victory. Your happiness is the ultimate victory, and this is what you are going to achieve. Helper of Thought, your life is about to start moving very fast. Events that seem to be on hold suddenly require all your attention. I was saying it may look slow, but it is definitely there. But with the Wheel of Fortune and with the Ace of Swords, things are going to move very fast. Okay, just see the beauty of the coordination of the cards. Okay, the events that seem to hold on suddenly require all the attention. There is no time to sit and ponder. You've got to get moving. You have to get moving. Review the details as best as you can. You know we'll meet, you know, or you will meet, or you are someone with a very quick mind who instantly grasps what to do. This person is both confident and courageous. So this person is confident, this person is courageous, this person has the strength, and this is your card, Leo's. In your reading, you are showing up as yourself in the dignified and a courageous manner. Okay, so you have to get the things moving. Review whatever you want to review. Think about if you have to correct anything, and things are going to roll on very fast. Now, two cards came out, number 5 and number 39. So, number 12 or number 3 may be of some significance for you. And number 5, simple acts of kindness. Kindness energizes you and brings happiness to those around you. So because it is a time for you also to heal, maybe you need to be kind to people around you. Because when you are kind to people, you give yourself happiness. It's not that they are happy, it's that you are happy. When you are kind to others, you have, the, just see this boy is feeding a small, this squirrel, and other animals have also gathered around. Just seeing that act of kindness, so it attracts people, it attracts positivity. Number 39, be authentic, be real and true to who you are and how you feel. So that's what I was saying, be in touch with yourself, heal yourself. Because if once you are in this stage, you are healing yourself, giving yourself time, be authentic with yourself. Okay, you should be honest with yourself as to whatever happened, whatever. Just see this maiden, she is a little sad, but the swan over here is all about positive. The sun over here, the butterfly, the fruit, everything in the surrounding, the flowers are pointing to positivity. So be real and true to who you are and how you feel. So first of all, you have to embrace the emotions within yourself. You have to understand as to what you feel and what you want. After that, you will be authentic to other people. And if you don't realize your own feelings, if you don't understand what you want, what is important for you, what is not important for you, then you can't put that into the environment, or you can't put that into the universe. So whatever it is, be authentic to yourself, be authentic to people around you, and just see, let everything go, just see what stays. Okay, come on, Leos. Thank you, and hope it helps. Please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.